In this video, we'd like to describe for you, or basically just answer the question, what is a JBox? In essence, a JBox, and the J stands for junction, and in some parts of the country or parts of the world, you might hear this also referred to as a summing box. And in a nutshell, the idea behind the JBox is to bring multiple load cells together so that they can function as a single scale. For example, a floor scale has four load cells in it. I'm going to need a place to bring all those load cells together because they're part of a single scale, and I only want one signal coming back to the indicator to tell me what the weight is. And so in a JBox, we have this capability where we're going to go ahead and we've got, in this example here, this is a four-channel JBox, so it allows me to bring up to four load cells in here. So I've got four different channels, and then I've got two spots here in the middle. One of these is going to wire back to the indicator. We would call that our home run cable, and that's where the signal is going to come back to the indicator so it can be interpreted by the A to D and give us a weight. The other connection block here is for an expansion. So I could daisy chain a couple of these four channel JBoxes together for an eight channel scale. For example, a truck scale might have eight load cells in it, so I could daisy chain a couple of four channel JBoxes together to bring all of those load cells to function as a single system. Now there are four major sort of purposes that we can get from a JBox that are worth noting. Two of them are sort of major purposes. One we just talked about, and that is to sum or bring all of these load cells together to function as a single system. And we don't want to confuse that with summing in terms of just adding together, because the JBox actually will average all of those load cell signals that are coming in from each of the individual cells. It doesn't simply add them together and send that to the indicator. It takes all of those values and sends an average value back to the indicator that we perceive as the weight. So that's the first main thing. Secondly, it allows us the ability to trim. Now, trimming is the act of creating the same signal to weight ratio between all of the load cells. Now you might look up in a catalog and find that a load cell has a 3 millivolt per volt value in terms of its rated output. But not every single load cell that you purchase is going to be exactly 3.0. You might have something that's, you know, 2.886, you might have another one that's 3.010, and several others in between. They're not going to be exactly the same. And those differences are enough to make it so that, for example, in my four-channel floor scale, if I had a 500-pound test weight, I might calibrate it and it will read 500 pounds in the center, as I would expect, but if I shift it slightly to one corner or another, I might see those differences in weight being picked up. And so these potentiometers, the little blue blocks here that are found on that JBox board, allow me to trim off those differences from cell to cell and create that same signal to weight ratio, so that no matter where I place the weight on the scale, I'm able to see the exact same weight as I expect. A couple other secondary types of purposes I might get from a JBox is the fact that this provides environmental protection for these bare wires and connections that are being made between the pieces of hardware. I have a stainless steel type of box here as an example. This is great for, you know, wash down types of environments so that all the wires and connections can be protected. But we can also place these in an FRP type enclosure where you might have a bit more chemically hazardous types of environments like fertilizer plants and things like that, where a stainless steel box would not be as effective in that particular type of situation. So we have that capability with the box here as well. And then finally, this provides a very convenient place for us to take all the necessary troubleshooting measurements that we might need to make, because all of my load cell connections are going to come into this one box together, and that's certainly a lot easier than running around underneath a truck scale that might have 8 or 10 load cells and trying to find them all individually. And so we have these couple of secondary purposes. So again, our JBox allows us to bring multiple load cells together to form a single scale, gives us the ability to trim off differences between cell to cell and achieve the same signal weight ratio so that I can read the same weight no matter where I am, provides environmental protection for all of my connections, and allows me a nice convenient place to take all of the measurements I need.